Hello guys, it's Deep Show here, and today I'm going to show you how to give this Joker effect to your photos in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop, then smash that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So this is the model image which I'll be using in order to create our Joker effect. So the first step over here we need to do is separate out the model from the background. So for that, select Quick Selection tool. And then using quick selection tool, make the selection of the model in the image. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. Now once the selection is complete, after that we need to get a proper selection of the hair and the beard over here. So for that, click on refine edge. And then using the brush, hover over the edges of the image. So as you can see, after using refine edge, our selection is looking perfect. After that, click on OK. Now after that, press Ctrl plus J to create a duplicate of this selection into a new layer. Now let's rename that layer as model. So now as you can see, we have separated out the model. Now let's start with the Joker effect. So first we will be starting out with the face. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option vibrance. After that, set the vibrance as 0 and then reduce the saturation to -100. After that, click on create clipping mask option so that this effect will be only applied to one underlying below it. After that, minimize it. Now after that, we want this effect to be only applied to the face of the model and not the neck and the hair portion over here. So for that, let's invert the mask by pressing Ctrl plus I. And then select brush tool. And then select any grunge brush. Download link for this grunge brush is in the description below. Also, if you don't know how to install this brushes in Photoshop, then all you need to do is download and extract the zip folder, and then after that click on this gear icon and then select option load brushes. After that, select the ABR file which you have extracted and then click on this load option over here. So after clicking on this load option, your brushes should start appear over here. Let me just cancel it as I have already loaded it, and then set the foreground color as white. And then click on OK. And then after that, make sure that the opacity and the flow of the brush is 100%. And then using the brush, hover over the face as follows. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. Don't hover over the eyes and the mouth over here. Now also, if you want to bring some part of the image back, then all you need to do is change the foreground color to black and then using the brush hover over the part which you want to bring it back. So as you can see, as you paint the mask using the black color, it will hide that portion, and as you paint the mask using the white color, it will bring back that portion. So let me just bring it back. So now as you can see, only the face has that effect. Now let's make sure that this effect blends in properly with the skin. So for that, click on add layer style option and then select option blending options. After that, you can play with this underlying layer slider to make it blend properly. After that, press alt and drag to divide the slider into a two. Drag this white underlying layer slider as well. So now this looks proper. After that, click on OK. Now after that, let's increase the whiteness to make it look more proper. So for that, again go to create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option exposure. After that, increase the exposure according to the whiteness you want over here. I'm setting it as 0.06. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then minimize it. So now after that, we want this exposure to be only applied to the face of the model. So for that, we have to create the same mask as that of the vibrant layer. So for that, press alt and then drag this mask of the vibrant layer to that of the exposure layer and then click on yes. So as you can see, we have copied the mask from that of the vibrant layer to the exposure layer. Now after that, we need to adjust the shadows and the midtones of the image. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option levels. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then adjust the shadows and the midtones accordingly. So now this looks proper. After that, minimize it. Now after that, let's give some touch ups to the face. So for that, make the mask of the vibrant layer active by clicking on it. And then select brush tool and then reduce the opacity of the brush to 50%. And then set the foreground color as black. After that, using the brush, click on the different portion of the face so that it exposes the skin and makes it look more realistic. Now this is looking proper. After that, make the levels layer active by clicking on it. Now after that, we need to start with the eyes portion of the Joker. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option exposure. After that, decrease the exposure according to the blackness you want around the eyes. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then minimize it. After that, let's invert the mask of the exposure by pressing Ctrl plus I and then rename that layer as left eye. We will be doing both the eyes separately as lighting around both the eyes is different. After that, make the mask of the left eye layer active by clicking on it. Now after that, select brush tool and then select any grunge brush. After that, make sure that the opacity is 100% and then the flow is also 100%. After that, set the foreground color as white and then using the brush tool, hover around the eyes as follows. Make sure you don't hover it inside the eyes. Now after that, we need to remove some of the portion of the blackness over here. So for that, again change the foreground color to black and then using the brush tool, hover over the portion which you want to remove. You can also play with the opacity of the brush and try to remove it. Now again, if you want to bring some part of the black portion back, then all you need to do is change the foreground color to white. So now as you can see, our left eye is now looking proper. Now we need to do the same thing for the right eye. So for that, again go to create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option exposure. After that, set the exposure according to the darkness you want. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then minimize it. After that, let's invert the mask by pressing Ctrl plus I. And now you need to do the same thing which you have done for the left eye over here. So now as you can see, both of the eyes have been done. Now let's start with the mouth of the Joker. So for that, again click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option use saturation. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then tick this colorize option. After that, set the hue as 0 and then you can set the saturation according to the redness you want over here. So now this looks proper. After that, let me just minimize it and then set the blend mode of the hue saturation layer to multiply. After that, press Ctrl plus I to invert the mask and then change the name of the layer to mouth. After that, make the mask of the mouth layer active by clicking on it and then select brush tool and then select any grunge brush and then increase the opacity to 100% and keep the flow as 100% and then set the foreground color as white and then using the brush tool, hover as follows. So now also over here, you can do the same thing like we did for the eyes over here by swapping between foreground color and the background color and also changing between the opacity of the brush. So now as you can see, our right portion of the mouth is looking proper, but our left portion of the mouth has a little light red color because of the lights on the face. So let's create one more hue saturation layer. So for that, again go to create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option hue saturation. After that, click on create clipping mask option and then select colorize option. After that, set the hue as 0 and then set the saturation greater than the previous one. This looks proper. After that, minimize it and then change the blend mode of that layer to multiply. And then rename that layer as left mouth. After that, make the mask of the left mouth layer active by clicking on it and then invert the mask by pressing Ctrl plus I. After that, using the brush only, bring that portion of the red color which is near the left portion of the mouth. Now over here also, you need to swap between the foreground color and the background color and also play with the opacity to find the best effect. So now as you can see, the mouth is now looking proper. Now let's give the green color to the hair to complete the Joker effect. So for that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. And then select the foreground color as any green color of your choice. I am selecting it as 20FE25 and then click on OK. Now after that, select brush tool and then select any grunge brush. Make sure that the opacity is 100% and the flow is also 100%. After that, using the brush, hover over the hair as follows. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to soft light. And then right click on the layer and then select option create clipping mask. And then reduce the opacity of the layer to 65%. Also reduce the fill of the layer to 65%. So now as you can see, the hair has the green color over here now. Now if you want to remove some portion of the green from the hair, then all you need to do is click on add layer mask icon. And then set the foreground color as black and then using brush tool hover over that portion which you want to remove. So now as you can see, our Joker effect is now complete. Now if you want to add the text which you saw in the thumbnail, then all you need to do is import that text image. Download link for that text image is in the description below. Now after that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now after that, we need to remove the white portion from the text over here. So for that, select magic wand tool. Now after that, using magic wand tool, click on the white portion of the image. After that, press shift and click on this inner portion for this R over here as well, and one more over here. After that, invert the selection by pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus I, and then click on add layer mask icon. So now as you can see, only the text is left. After that, press Ctrl plus T and then scale it and place it properly. Press shift while scaling to scale evenly. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now after that, we need to give this grunge effect to the text over here as well. So for that, select brush tool and then select any grunge brush. Make sure that the opacity is 100% and the flow is also 100%. After that, set the foreground color as black and then click on the document where you want to add the grunge effect. After that, reduce the opacity of the text layer to 75%. So that's it guys, this will give you your Joker effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.